Let's pray. Father in heaven, we bow before you in the name of Jesus Christ, and we're claiming the promise of Proverbs chapter 18. Your words are clear. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth therein and is safe. Lord, while the world is seeking and crying peace and safety, looking in the wrong direction, looking to the wrong persons, today we look to Jesus Christ. Revive us, reform us, is our prayer. And bless us now, we pray, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Greetings, salutations. Welcome to this Midday Power Surge, Friday, December 11th, 2020. This is your spiritual oasis on this pilgrim journey. Safe to Serve International, first-time viewers, I greet you as strangers and pilgrims on this earth. When the sun sets, the Lord's Sabbath begins. And there are other places in the world. The Sabbath has already begun. And remember, my friends, don't you forget, the seventh day is still the Sabbath, and Jesus is coming soon. Get ready. Remain ready. Get others ready. As we go throughout this lesson, my friends, by God's grace, we are going to receive, as I've always said, spiritual soul food, not junk food. Is that point clear? Let's get right into it, my friends. We are told in the book, volume 5 and page 452, that the Sunday movement is making its way in darkness. Yes, friends. And there is going to be an ominous showdown, a great crisis. The remnant people of God who receives and proclaims God's three angels' messages are going to encounter a great war. War against whom? Well, the Bible tells us against the three apostate powers. God's people receive and proclaim the three angels' messages of Revelation 14, the everlasting gospel. And Christ, as a result, will have a harvest of souls, a gathering. That's verse 6 through verse 16. On the contrary, Satan is going to do everything he can to counterfeit and to oppose the receiving, the proclaiming of God's three angels' messages. Who will Satan use? The three apostate powers of Revelation chapter 16, verse 13 and verse 14. And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon, out of the mouth of the beast, out of the mouth of the false prophet. These are spirits of devils working miracles. And the Bible says they go out unto the kings of the earth and of the whole world to gather people unto Satan, to war against Christ, to war against Jesus in the person of his saints. And that's what we find in Revelation chapter 12 and verse 17, the great war. I could take the time right now and address in a Bible study who the dragon is, the beast is, the false prophet is of Revelation 16, 13, and 14. But let me give you a truncated version. That beast power represents the papacy of Revelation 13, 1 through 10. The false prophet represents apostate Protestantism from Revelation 19, 19 and 20, and Revelation 13, 11 through 17. The dragon power has three primary applications. Dragon, firstly represents the civil authorities, civil leaders like Pharaoh, that great red dragon brought to view in Ezekiel, Herod, that great red dragon brought to view in Revelation 12. The dragon also represents paganism. The dragon, spiritualism. And friends, as we can see right here, a war is coming. And while individuals have been inundated with the news reports regarding pestilence 19, the pestilence panacea, policies to combat the pestilence, my friend, the Sunday movement is making its way in darkness. The three apostate powers are uniting. Take a look at this, my friends. The three apostate powers are uniting due to their clandestine and even their public convocations, their public gatherings. All right, friends. Look prayerfully, listen and read. All right, friends. Have you ever heard of Rally of Hope? I took a few clippings from the actual website, Rally of Hope. It took place December 5th through December 6th. How many of you were aware of that? Just as I said, while people were focusing on the Pestilence 19 and Pestilence Elixir, the policies to combat Pestilence 19, the three apostate powers took one step to completely unite. Look at this, my friends. Again, I'm going to post the links in the description below. Many times, the actual title does not contain all that we have to share as a synopsis of the materials, the substance in each presentation. So kindly look at the description box below on this YouTube channel beneath each video. Look at this, Rally of Hope, to celebrate the 1 year anniversary of the World Christian Leadership Conference, also known as WCLC, and support what, friends? The realization of a heavenly united, heavenly unified world. So what are they calling for with all these world religions uniting? Will that also include popery? All right. The same website. Look at the top. Again, I'm not going to read every single sentence, but I'm picking out points that I believe are important. It says, what are they calling for, blue words? A heavenly unified world. Look at the bottom there. I circled that in red. They're calling for and uniting for a world of interdependence, mutual prosperity, universal values in which humanity breathes and lives together, transcending, watch this, transcending all religious barriers. Will this bring about a one world religion? Then it says, transcending national barriers, a one world government. The three apostate powers, dragon, beast, false prophet. Look at this, my friend. Same website, Rally of Hope. From left to right, I read, realizing one human family, one family of humankind. Left corner, red arrow. They're calling for, rallying for, a worldwide peace movement conducted under the solidarity and cooperation of heads of state. Dragon power. Go to the right of the screen. Right arrow. A global interreligious and interdenominational peace movement led by representatives of various faiths. The faith power now would bring to view the beast and the false prophet. Would that include popery? Would that include apostate Protestantism? Yes. And the dragon power, not only nations, civil leaders, but also pagan religions, Hinduism, Buddhism. You know what I'm talking about. Let's get back. Who else are in league? This rally of hope. You mean rally of destruction? It says from left to right, media professionals are also having a working synergy with these players. Movement of scholars. That's your academic and academia. Right corner, economic, the merchants, our friends. Revelation 18, verse 2, verse 3. Let's move on. A movement to build a world of peace. The center statement. It's a proposal of alternative solutions for the eradication of poverty and hunger. Well, since it's a unification of world religions, what has popery must be enacted by every nation to combat, to counteract, to solve poverty and hunger. Is it not Sunday rest by law? And what will happen to God's remnant people who refuse to bow? Persecution, friends. Rally of hope. Hope for whom? Those who go along with popery. But what about God's people? And remember, based on scripture, watch this point. Don't miss it. I want to be very candid right now. Based on scripture, Daniel chapter 8, the Bible says in verse 23 through verse 25, popery is called the man of peace. Now I'm going to share with you. And by peace shall he destroy many. With that in mind, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 3 says, for when they shall say peace and safety, watch out, sudden destruction, not only upon them, the seven last plagues and the second death, but they will attempt to destroy God's remnant faithful people. All right, here's the point now. Man of sin, I'm going to share with you now the mother of sin. Man of peace, the mother of peace. By the way, the man of peace, popery, pope means papa. Papa means father, not my father. Man of peace, father of peace, in league with mother of peace. Mother in prophecy, religions, churches. Are you seeing it? While many are focusing on the man of sin, the man of peace, popery, don't take your eyes off the churches, the daughters. Look at this, friends. There it is. This rally of peace. Look at that. Hosted by the mother of peace. What is she doing? Calling all believers to unite and heal the world. The mother of peace, also called, I believe, Paula White, called the Mother of Peace, Mother Moon. Yes, M-O-O-N, Mother Moon. I'll get to that shortly. Look at this, my friends. World Christian Leadership Conference Rally and Convocation in 2020. Let's move on. Listen to this now, friends. Watch this introduction. Paula White, listen. You know what? I'm going to hold that video until we move on. I'm going to replay this. Please watch the words as I read. Take a look at this. In our world, beautiful places, vibrant cultures, expressions of faith, and ways of worship. My friends, does that sound like pluralism? Think about it, friends. Does that sound like relativism? Many cultures, many ways of worship. Notice now in the second clip, Again, this is the so-called rally of hope that took place just a few days ago, December 5th, December 6th, 2020. Now they are going to say, we are going to rally. Rally means to gather, if you missed it. We will gather all religions, all nations, to bring about peace in the love of Jesus, the love of God. Love, love without obeying God's commandments is spiritism. It's spiritualism. It's deceptive. Take a look at this. Clip two. That's too loud. Listen. Christ taught us to love one another, even though we are so different. In giving his life for others, he showed an example of love that unites all Christians as one body of love. It's time to unite all Christians in one body of love. But my friends, what does the Bible say in John 14, 15? All these religions, along with popery, apostate Protestants, and also spiritualistic religions, love, my friends, Jesus said in John 14, 15, if you love me, keep my commandments. Anything contrary is satanic. And let me say this, some of the common people are simply ignorant, but the majority of the leaders, don't miss this, the majority of the leaders in this movement, yes, my friends, they know exactly what they are doing to destroy God's faithful people, commandment-keeping people. All right, do you remember Judas Iscariot? Did he not praise Christ and kiss Christ? Mwah. I love you, but what happened? He betrayed Christ. Let's unite in love. Take a look at this statement, my friends. Great controversy. Page 558 says, even in its present form, spiritualism, blue words on top, is really a more dangerous, because a more subtle deception. Red words, love is dwelt upon as the chief attribute of God, but it is degraded to a weak sentimentalism, making little distinction between good and evil. Watch this, blue words, God's justice, his denunciations of sin, the requirements of his holy law, are all kept out of sight. The people are taught to regard the Decalogue as a dead letter. Pleasing, bewitching fables captivate the senses. The three unclean spirits like frogs. Last sentence, Christ is as verily denied as before, but Satan has so blinded the eyes of the people that the deception is not discerned. It's spiritualism. Let's unite just on love. Look at this one more time, my friends. It says, unite them in one body, the body of love. Look at this. In giving his life for others, they said, Christ showed an example of love that unites all Christians as one body of love. Look at this statement, my friends. Great controversy, page 588. And Satan determines to unite them in one body. Red words, one body. One body. And thus strengthen his cause by sweeping all into the ranks of spiritualism. Blue words, papists, Protestants, worldlings will all alike accept the form of godliness without the power, and they will see in this union a grand movement for the conversion of the world and the ushering in of the long expected millennium, along the long expected era of peace. Clear as day, my friends. And remember in scripture, body means church. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 25 through verse 28. Look at this now. Let's come to Paula White Cain. Listen to what she said.
With you. And
This is her opening remarks.
With you, and what an encouragement to the body of Christ and to you, Mother Moon, for your tireless efforts and your work as you have continued to bring faith leaders from all over the world to work together in peace and unification, to bring together people for the better cause. I congratulate you.
So who is doing this, my friends? Mother Moon. Who is Mother Moon? The mother of peace, as I showed you earlier on the actual website, Rally of Hope. By the way, look at the headline on YouTube, Rally of Hope. She was one of the speakers. All right, friend, let's all unite religions. Watch the daughters. You remember Herod, John the Baptist? What led to John being beheaded? Not Herodias in the public's eye, but Herodias had a clandestine meeting with her daughter Salome. And Salome went public and demanded the head of John the Baptist. Watch the daughters. Let's move on. Here comes Paula White Cain. Just to quote now, 2 Chronicles 7, verse 13, verse 14. In a time of pestilence, it's time for us to unite. Listen.
Need to do in our life as we repent and we pray and we fast, we know that God will heal our land. God wants to bring restoration. So I pray that you, myself, along with Mother Moon, will be a part of that great restoration.
Restoration, friends. With popery, that's Revelation 13:3. Move on. And now, friends, we are seeing Paula White Cain is going to quote Matthew 12 and verse 30. I have one question. Is she implying, did Satan give her that scripture? Big picture, is she implying if we don't unite with this movement, dragon, beast, false prophet, we are going to be persecuted? She actually said it's a particular spirit that is behind this movement. Take a listen. Take a look.
Jesus said it like this in Matthew chapter 12, verse 30. He said, "Whoever is not with me is against me. And whoever does not gather, scatters." We thank you for that spirit of gathering on you, Mother Moon. May the spirit of gather come upon you right now. And may God do a great work to gather us together.
My friends, is Christ gathering? Yes, he is. What scripture, particularly last days, Revelation 14. Verse 6 to verse 12, the three angels' messages. Verse 14 to verse 16, you see the gathering. Thrust in thy sickle and reap. Gather the harvest. But Satan is also gathering. What scripture? Revelation 16, verse 13 and verse 14. And how are they gathering? Not based on Bible doctrines, God's Ten Commandments, just in the name of love and love your brother. Listen to this, my friend. The next clip says, quoting John 3:16, God the Father did not send his son to this world because he loved the church. Oh no. Because he loved individuals. Oh no. It was because he loved the world. So now let's save the world. Different religions, it doesn't matter how they worship, they are still going to be saved. Pluralism, a deception of Satan. Look at this, my friends.
God so loved the world. God did not love the church or the individual so much that he sent his only begotten son. It was because God loved the world.
There it is, my friends. Do you know what came to my mind? Because they are not uniting based on God's law. Let's love your brethren. Look, write these scriptures down. And these are the scriptures. One, we must reflect upon, we must live, and we must also share with those who are part of this movement. Bear in mind, these leaders have great clout, influence over many churches and people, religions and people. Let's begin to evangelize aggressively and effectively, exposing, uncovering Satan's wiles and Satan's tactics. 1 John chapter 4, verse 19 says, we love Christ, we love him because he first loved us. Since they are emphasizing love and love and love, here's my point now. We love him because he first loved us. And what says John 14, 15? If you love me, do what now? Keep my commandments, which include the seventh day Sabbath. So these movements, Hope Rally, WCLC, all uniting. Are they uniting on God's law? If not, it's a deception of Satan. For 2 John, what's the focus? Love each other. 2 John, only one chapter, verse 5, it says, and now I beseech you, lady, not as though I wrote a new commandment, the church, but that which we had from the beginning, that you love one another. That's the theme that they are promoting. And this is the love, that we walk after his commandments. As we have in the context, loving our brother, what does the Bible say? And this is love, that we walk after God's commandments. If it's not after God's commandment, it's not love, it's hate. Verse 7, for many deceivers are entered into the world, and they have the spirit of the Antichrist. That's verse 7. Skip on down to verse 9. So who's behind this movement? The Antichrist. Look at verse 9 through verse 11. It says, don't even bid them Godspeed. Don't say amen to this movement. Don't pray for the success of this movement. Pray for those who have been deceived to be enlightened and call out from Babylon. Verse 9. Whosoever transgresses and abides not in the doctrine of Christ hath not God. Keep God's commandments. Verse 10, if there come any unto you and bring not this doctrine with God's commandments, receive him not into your house. Don't even live stream their convocation. Neither bid him Godspeed. Why? For he that biddeth him Godspeed is partaker of his evil deeds. Are these scriptures clear? May I give you one more? 1 John chapter 5, look at verse number 2. It says, but this we know, that we love God's children. Love your neighbor. When we love God and keep his commandments. How many more scriptures you need? Verse 3, for this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. 1 John chapter 4, verse 20 says, it says, he that loveth not his brother and claims he loves God is a liar. Look now at verse number 17. Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as Christ is, so are we in this world. Was Christ pure? Yes. How should we be found pure? Is God's law the standard of purity? Yes. Write down 1 John chapter 3, verse 1 and verse 3. Are these points clear, my friends? Notice 1 John chapter 2, Bible for your feet, verse number 4. He that saith, I know him, all right, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoso keepeth his word, in him verily is the love of God perfected. This is how we know that we know Christ. Let's get back here. Are these points clear? Notice here, my friends. In the next video, it says, or a path to world peace continues. Do you know what I say? The path to carry on Protestantism continues. The protest continues. Look at this, my friends. Or a path toward a peaceful world continues. Rally of hope. It's a false hope, my friends. False hope. False hope. And this is why we are told in Psalm 119, verse 165, the Bible says, great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. You cannot have a God-driven movement of world peace, peace with religions, peace with nations and civil authorities by excluding the law. And then they claim they're standing on the word of God. It is a deception, my friends. Are we encountering a great war? Let me tell you something. Don't be trepid. God is looking for gallant, faithful, bold Christians. Watch this. 1 John chapter 4. The Bible tells us in verse number 18. It says, there is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out fear. Amen. Because fear hath torment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. Don't be fearful, my friends. Spend time in prayer. Look at this here, friends. Don't you miss this. Please don't miss this. Do not fear the three rogue apostate powers, three unclean spirits. Look at the last segment as I close. December 9, 2020. What is a headline here from one of the three unclean spirits? What is the headline here from one of the three apostate powers, rogue powers? Headline, even death trembles when a Christian prays. This is what the man of sin just said. Popery, even death trembles when a Christian prays. Now, friends, this is the height of papal arrogance and papal ignorance. Watch the steps right here as I bring this to a close. Even death trembles when a Christian prays. What is the root cause of death? Watch this. Romans 6 verse 23 says, for the wages of sin is death. Death trembles when the Christian prays. All right, next step. Who is called and labeled the man of sin in the Bible? Popery. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 3 and verse 4. Let's put this in the title now. Even the papacy trembles when a Christian prays. Did you see that, friends? Do you see it? All right. Notice now this statement from Great Controversy, page 127. The prayers of Martin Luther, the reformer, blue words, but the very means adopted for Rome's aggrandizement provoked the deadliest blow to her power and greatness. It was this that aroused the most determined and successful of the enemies of popery and led to the battle that shook the papal throne and jostled the triple crown upon the pontiff's head. Babylon is fallen. Popery is fallen. Is fallen. And that's why we're told in Great Controversy again, page number 210, about Martin Luther and the Protestant reformer, we are told, during the struggle at Augsburg, Luther did not allow one day to pass without spending at least 3 hours in prayer. And hours were selected from these, the most favorable for study, prayer. As a result, my friends, go back to the headline. As a result, even popery trembles when a faithful, a sincere Christian prays. And who's behind popery, my friends? Satan is behind popery. And what are we told in James 2 verse 9? Even the devils tremble. When I read that from the man of sin, even death trembles. Even Satan trembles now is the application. When a Christian prays, my mind, I record statements in the spirit of prophecy, which says Satan trembles. Satan flees when a sincere follower of Christ prays. There are a plethora of statements that say that. I'm simply going to give you two. Ready for it, friends? For them? Look at this. Here it is, my friends. The Desire of Ages, page 130. Here's one of my opening scriptures. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runs into it and is safe. Proverbs 18:10. Blue words on top. Satan trembles. Satan flees before the weakest soul who finds refuge in the mighty name. Mercy, friends. I refuse to close Midday Power Surge without giving you hope. That's why it's called Midday Power Surge. Next quote. It says, I'm going to read all of it. It says, but if one in danger perseveres and in his helplessness casts himself upon the merits of the blood of Christ, or a Savior Jesus listens to the earnest prayer of faith and sends a reinforcement of those angels that excel in strength to deliver him. Red word, Satan cannot endure to have his powerful rival appealed to. That's Christ. Satan cannot endure to have his powerful rival appealed to. Why? Because Satan fears and trembles before Christ's strength and majesty. At the sound of fervent prayer, not only Satan, at the sound of fervent prayer, not only Satan, but Satan's whole host trembles. Praise God. Why? Well knowing that their battle is lost. That's why we are told in the same book, Great Controversy, page 519, Satan well knows all whom he can lead to neglect prayer, and the searching of scriptures will be overcome by his attacks. Therefore, he introduces every possible device to engross our minds. I want Satan to tremble and flee from me for good. How about you? What are we to do based on those statements? You know, friends, I'm going to close with this song. Several songs came to my mind. Hillary? All right. What a friend we have in Jesus. Send in your prayer requests. The Sabbath is upon us. The second coming of Christ is upon us. We want power, my friends, not fear. Faith above fear. What a friend we have in Jesus. Listen.
What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God in and temptations. Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful, who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness, so take it to the Lord in prayer.
Father in heaven, we're thankful for this midday power surge. The crisis is upon us, but we have faith in Jesus Christ. May we spend much time in fasting, in praying, claiming your promises, that Satan and his whole host will tremble and flee. And your presence, the Holy Spirit, the holy angels, may come and minister unto us. Save us, we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thou wilt find us solace there.